plus and a minus in my parentheses. Now I have to find the factors of 21 that subtract to give me 4. Anybody know what those are? Well, we have 1 and 21 and 3 and 7. Exactly, 3 and 7. Where's the larger number going? Next to the plus or the minus? Right. It's got to go next to the positive number because we have a positive 4 in the middle. So our 7 goes next to the plus, our 3 goes next to the minus. Now, remember I just told you, if x plus 7 equals 0, the whole thing is 0. So x would have to be what? What plus 7 gives me 0? And see how it comes out as a negative 7? So now, in this one, x would be what? Positive 3. Exactly.
In Brooklyn, she's such a jerk.
I know, like, she acts like she owns everything.
I know,
like,
what she's wearing today? Ew.
It's so ugly.
Like, why would you wear that?
My expectations are that you will come to class on time, you'll work hard, you'll turn your assignments in, and you allow yourself to fail, because mistakes are how you learn. Projects that we've done in the past are learning about franchises, and when we've talked about marketing, we've done cereal boxes, and we study different types of countries. Sean says, keep your phone away. I don't have an answer for that one, honestly. Cole says it's typing, but Sean says, according to YouTube, I'm slow. Plus, I don't like to lose, so I'd have to win the gold.
What are your expectations for your classroom?
My expectations. One, no cuss words. Two, follow directions, come prepared, and to learn.
Man, I'm like struggling with dog classes here. You can tell us.
Are you bringing your Florida class every day?
No.
Are you chewing gum in class?
Yeah.
Are you even talking between songs?
Pretty much.
You know those all things she hates.
Yeah, you're right.
Yeah,
I guess you're straight enough.
Yeah, you're straight enough.
Nice.
Yeah.
I just wanna stay in the sun where I find. I know it's hard sometimes. Pieces of peace in the sun's peace of mind. I know it's hard sometimes.
Man, I'm really struggling with vlog sauce this year. Can you give me some advice?
Are you bringing your forward class every day?
No.
Are you chewing gum in between?
Yeah. Am I supposed to be chewing gum in between it?
Fairfield High School in the 2018-2019 school year, people. Welcome to Fairfield High School in the 2018-2019 school year for all you freshmen. These are tips how to pass Mr. Mill and Mr. Vivian's science class. Do your work on time when they tell you to turn it in. Ask questions on everything, every subject they teach you. Take notes on everything. Do not talk back to your teachers because they will be very angry with you. Try to have an answer to all their questions, even if they are questions you do not know. The end.
I'm going to give you all some tips on how to do Mr. Denny's class.
I think being a part of that is that's what I
do. Do your work.
Keep your binders sorted.
What are some of your pet peeves when students are in your classroom?
Pet peeves. Well, definitely talking when I'm talking is a pet peeve. If you you can't hear instructions, then I have to repeat myself. And I already teach classes 6 times, 7 times a day. So talking when the teacher's talking is a big one. The water bottle flipping was kind of a big deal for a while, but not too bad.
What about like having your phone out?
Actually, that as long as you're not like, for me, as long as they're not like
Fortnite,
you know, yeah, if they're not playing a game, you know, adults do that too. They'll have a phone out, see the message, put it down. I'm usually okay with that. But you know, if you're using it responsibly, it's not an issue. If you're using it irresponsibly, then it is an issue. So,
what's your second question?
What are some of your expectations when students enter your classroom?
Like for. Well, the main expectation is just try your best. You need to make sure you work hard, do all your work. You know, I don't really expect every single student to pass every assessment. I mean, so that's why I try to have some other types of grades in there to help you out. So if you have a folder grade, that helps. If you do the homework, that helps. Because I know not everyone's a world history expert. My goal is to get every student to pass all the assessments, but I know realistically that doesn't always happen.
Well, how often do we have homework in this class? Like,
well, we have homework about once a chapter, so that's usually about every 2 weeks we have an assignment. I do a vocab assignment. That's the way it's been for a few years now. Next year, when we go to one-to-one, I'm going to figure something else out. And we'll start doing Google Classroom, and there might be smaller assessments, smaller assignments that might be a little bit more often. I'm still figuring that out, though.
So what exactly kind of subjects do we go over, like the World War II, World War I, whatever?
We start at the Age of Enlightenment, so that's roughly about the 16, 1700s, but we move pretty quick. We go from there and we talk about how that those ideas shaped the American Revolution. American Revolution shapes the French Revolution. Napoleon Bonaparte comes out of the French Revolution. Then we talk about the rise of nationalism. The Industrial Revolution, imperialism, so making empires, and those things lead to World War One, and eventually we talk about World War One. We talk about the Great Depression. We talk about how all those things lead to World War Two, and World War Two leads to the Cold War, and the Cold War leads to today.